Hey y'all, my name is Yvette and welcome to my channel. Today I'll be talking about my TBR for this year's round of the Latinxathon. The Latinxathon is a readathon where we read books by Latinx authors. It's running from October 6th to October 15th. I am one of the co-hosts, and if you want more details, I'll link my announcement video down below. So I have quite a few books on my TBR this year, but most of them are really short things that I'm probably gonna breeze through, so hopefully I'll get through most of this TBR. And also, I am going to try to be focusing on books that I already own, and that's not a readathon thing, that's just a me thing. So the first book I'm going to be talking about today is Goddess of Filth by V. Castro, and this would go for the prompts of something spooky and something short because I think this is around 140 pages. This is about five Chicanos who live in San Antonio, and they're 1 year out of high school when they decide to try to emulate the movie The Craft and hold a seance. And things start to go wrong when one of the girls starts chanting in Nahuatl. Over the next few weeks, the girl's personality seems to change, and she changes the way she dresses, and she starts tearing her hands up on rose thorns. So her friends go to a priest, and the priest says that she is possessed by a demon, but the friends aren't so sure that that's what's wrong with her. I got this book because I heard it described as The Craft but Latinx, and the cover is really cool, so yeah, I'm really looking forward to reading this one, especially because the author is Tejana. The next book I have in my TBR is Her Night with Santa by Adriana Herrera, and this would go for the prompts of something cozy and something short because this is 71 pages. This is an FF erotic holiday romance by an author who I've read and loved, and like, I've read two of her previous holiday romances and I love both of those, so I have very high expectations for this one. This novella is following the niece of the King of Magi. She has had a pretty tough year, so she's decided to spend a night at Santa's secret beach villa with a bunch of sex toys. At the same time, the first female Santa has decided to take a night off, and she decides to spend it at her beach villa, and when she walks into her bedroom, she walks into the other woman in her bed. This sounds like it's just gonna be mindless holiday fun, which is something I would describe as cozy. The next thing I'm hoping to read is What the Hex by Alexis Daria, and this would go for the process of cozy because I find romance is very cozy, and short because the audio is 2 hours and 45 minutes. This is a romance novella that takes place in a secret magical enclave in Miami that is home to the richest Latinx families. The main character, Catalina, comes home for her sister's wedding only to find that her new brother-in-law has been possessed by a demon and all the guests are under his influence. The only other person who's not under the influence is her old childhood rival, and they have to work together to figure out what's going on. The next thing I want to read is Nightfall by Marisela Trevino Orta, and this would go for the prompts of something spooky and something short because the audio is 1 hour and 41 minutes long. This one is a horror audio play, and it's about a stepmother and a stepdaughter who are out on a bonding camping trip when there's a zombie outbreak in a nearby city and they have to survive it together. I am super excited for this one, not only because it's about zombies and I love zombies, but also this is a play. And I don't think I've read a play since I was in college, and this was a play made for audio, so I think they have like a full cast and everything, so it should be a pretty good reading experience. The next thing I want to read is My Body Herself by Carmen Maria Machado, and this would go for something spooky and something short because it's on audio and it's only 13 minutes long. This is a horror short by one of my favorite authors, and I have no idea what it's about. The Goodreads description only reads, "A woman learns that death is not the loneliest thing." So that sounds ominous, but also like it's gonna be really good. The next book I'm hoping to read is Margarita in the Spotlight by Maria Fraser, and this would go for something cozy because it is a middle grade and I find middle grades very cozy. This is about a girl who plays the banjo in her stepsister's country band, and she's not actually all that passionate about music, but she's here to support her sister, which makes things kind of complicated when the band is thrust into the spotlight after an article is written up about the lack of diversity in country music. The next book I want to read is The Inheritance of Orquídea Divina by Zoraida Cordova, and this would go for the challenge of reading something with a fall cover because the background of this book is red. I'm not entirely sure what this book is about, like even after I read the summary a couple times I'm still not sure, but from what I gather it is about Orquídea's descendants and they've gotten some gifts from her and they're being picked off one by one by something, so they have to go to Ecuador to figure out what's going on. I have an audiobook of this from Libre FM and like it's already downloaded and ready to play, and I'm just like holding myself back from starting it until the readathon starts. The next book I'm hoping to read is Our Mind World, Poetics of Resistance in Guatemala, and I don't think this falls under any prompts, but I just really want to read this book. From what I can tell, this is a nonfiction book about indigenous Guatemalan literature and poetry and like how authors have used words in their process of decolonization. I am under no illusion that I'm going to finish this during the readathon because I just don't read physical books like that, but I at least want to get started on it and carve out a chunk or two especially considering that the movie we're going to be watching during the Latinxathon is about indigenous Guatemalans, and this seems like a good thing to read alongside of watching that. So those are all the books I own and the ones that I want to make a priority during this readathon, but also there are some books at the library that I have my eye on that I really want to read, and some that I have on hold that might come off of hold during this readathon, so I don't know, I might read these instead, but I'm just gonna go quickly through them, not too in depth. The first one is going to be Simone Breaks All the Rules by Debbie Rigaud, and this is a YA contemporary, I think, from a Haitian or Haitian American author, I'm not sure. I just heard good things about this book. The next one is going to be Night Blooming Jasmine by Jasmine Mendez, and this is a series of essays and poetry about chronic illness and infidelity. I am extra interested in this one because I saw the author on a panel last year at Latinx Heritage Book Fest, and she was really good, and this book recently became available at my library, and it seems like, you know, something's pushing me to read this at this time. I also have on hold Fire with Fire by Destiny Soria, and I am not sure what this was about. I know it has to do with dragons and sisters and a sister that is queer, but besides that, I forget what it's about, but I mean, that's enough to make me excited about it. Another book I have on hold is A Massacre in Mexico by Annabelle Hernandez, and this is a nonfiction book about the 43 Mexican students who went missing and the government tried to cover it up. And finally, the last book I might read for the Latinxathon is Cazadora by Romina Garber, and this is the second book in a YA fantasy series about werewolves. The first book in that series is so good, and I think that if anything's gonna throw off my TBR, it's this book coming off of hold in the middle of the readathon. So yeah, that is going to be my TBR for this year's round of the Latinxathon. If you are participating, let me know what you're reading in the comments below. I hope y'all enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.